Sweeney. Dwayne Sweeney. Can you please hand it over to your captain, Dwayne Sweeney?
Hello and welcome to Real Tales with Sweens. On today's episode, it's going to be just me sharing a little bit about myself, about my background, my passions, and why I've decided to start this podcast, how I'm going to do it, who I'm going to connect with, and also to say some thank yous to some amazing people that have helped me get to this point. The main hub for this podcast will be my website, realtaleswithsweens.com. You can also follow the journey through my Instagram, which is @realtaleswithsweens, and I'll also post up all the show notes for this episode on both platforms. I'm really excited about this journey and really looking forward to it, so hope you all enjoy the podcast. Who is Dwayne Sweeney, or Sweens? Sweens is what I respond to. I only really get called Dwayne if I'm in trouble from mum. My background, I'm a professional rugby player, have been for 19 seasons. I started playing for Waikato as a 17-year-old schoolboy back in 2002. I'm super keen outdoorsman. I love the outdoors. I love hunting and fishing, and that stemmed from, I guess, my family upbringing. So I'm a very family-orientated person. I've three younger brothers, so I'm the oldest of four boys. We don't have any sisters, and so our poor mum, yes, I know. And yeah, dad's just always been super keen on the outdoors, always loved us hunting and fishing, so we naturally, a natural progression was that, you know, every kid looks up to their dad, and that's what we got into, and we're all super passionate about it, and we have some amazing times doing that. Grew up in Morrinsville. It's a dairy farming capital of New Zealand, so I'm pretty sure it still holds that title. It's the town slogan is cream of the country, so it's pretty cool, and that's part of our team song for my local club team, Morrinsville Sports. I won't sing it for you though, because I'm a terrible singer. I went across to Hamilton for high school. I went to Hamilton Boys High. Definitely wasn't the rugby superpower that it is now with the New Zealand high school sport, but it was a very good school, especially locally here in the Waikato when I went there. But the things that stand out for me about my time at Hamilton Boys was the quality of I guess teachers and mentors that we had through the school in terms of our sports team coaches. So I was sort of into everything at high school, like sort of most, you know, teenage Kiwis are. And you know, I played first 11 cricket, first team rugby. I rode. I was in the Māori Cup 8. My professional career kicked off while I was at Hamilton Boys High. I was sitting in mass, and I got a note to go to the principal's office. Never normally a good thing when you're at school to get a note from the runner to go to the principal's office. So I shot over to the front office, and I was coming up with all sorts of excuses of things that I thought that I was in trouble for. And I walked into the front office, and Barbara Clark was there. She's still in the front office now at Hamilton Boys High, and she's a legend. She's the first 15 manager, was for a long time before I played first 15, and I started with the first 15 in the year 2000. So she had this big grin on her face when I walked in, and I sit down, and I'm still super nervous, sweaty teenager, you know, I walk into, and then Miss Hassel walks out, the principal of Hamilton Boys High, and she tells me to come in, and she's got this big smile too, and look, small chit chat, and then she gives me a piece of paper. She's like, "All right, you need to ring this number." So I was like, "Okay, cool." So I ring the number. The phone is answered, and it's Ian Foster, the current All Black coach now, but at the time he was the current Waikato NPC coach. And he said, "Oh, do you know who I am?" And you know, I was pretty starstruck, but I think I got the words out eventually that I knew who he was. And he said, "Can you get the afternoon off school?" So I asked Miss Hassel, and she said, "Yep, that's fine." And he goes, "Oh, can you get the rest of the week off actually?" And she's, "Yeah." So I asked again. She said, "Yep, that's fine." Then he said, "Oh, have you got your boots at school?" I said, no, not today. He goes, "All right, can you shoot home and grab them and then meet me at the stadium at 2:00? And I was like, "Oh, yeah." He goes, "Yeah, because you're going to train with us and then you're going to make your Waikato debut on Friday versus Hawke's Bay." And I, tears start streaming down my cheeks. I got goosebumps all over. It was just an amazing feeling. And I can, you know, what's it? 18 years on now, I can still remember that moment so vividly in my mind. It was such a huge amount of emotions took over, and being a born and bred Waikato kid, I just loved the team. They were super successful through the 90s, and there was only one team that I ever wanted to play for, and that was Waikato, and to get that phone call as a 17-year-old, it was a very surreal moment. I just remember, you know, the team was led by Dion Muir, and guys like Todd Miller was still playing, and it was just, you know, Jono Gibbs, Marty Holler, Roger Randall, Bruce Rahan, and like the list of names goes on. Even some of the guys I debuted with, Stephen Bates, Regan King, like they all went, Keith Robinson, Lockie Crichton, like they all went on to be international players, All Blacks, and Lockie played for Samoa. And yeah, it was just a super, super exciting time, and just something that I'll remember forever. I suppose from there, then I went on to play for Waikato. I became a centurion last year, so I became Waikato's 22nd centurion, which was amazing. It was so cool to, I guess, be in a position to be able to celebrate such an awesome occasion. Like, I got to run out with my two boys, Cooper and Mason, and you know, my wife Marie was there on the sideline, and some of the past greats made a little, I guess, a guard of honor for me to walk out through onto the field, and it was just an amazing occasion. So I touched on it a little bit there, but in terms of my passions, like what gets me out of bed in the morning, I suppose, is rugby, obviously, hunting, fishing, my family. But I also have like a really strong passion like for my local community. And I suppose that stems from growing up in a small town where you kind of know everybody, you support everyone, you know all the businesses, you know who runs the businesses, you know who ran the business before them because it was their dad or their uncle or auntie or whatever it may be. So for me, like I've really liked to stay connected to my local community and support those people, I guess, around me in whatever way I can. I also have a huge passion for, I guess, sharing my knowledge. I've really enjoyed doing in my later part of my career is helping my teammates around me succeed, because I know that whether you turn up on your first day or you've been there for, you know, nearly 20 years like I have, it's a team sport, and the only way that you're gonna be successful is if you're all in it together and you're working well as a team. So that's something I'm hugely passionate about. And just connecting with good people. Like I love conversation. I love having a yarn. Like those people that know me, they'll be laughing and or nodding their heads right now. They'll be like, yep, he does love having a yarn, whether it's on the phone, over a beer, over a coffee. It's just, I really, really enjoy conversation and sharing stories, hearing people's stories. Like I'm super passionate about that there. Yeah, so yep, that's a little bit about my passions. Podcast why. So I think it's important to let you know why I've decided to do this podcast, and I think for me, like, it kind of ties into a lot into those passions. So I'm passionate about conversation, I'm passionate about sharing, I'm passionate about learning, and what better way to do it than to be able to get alongside people, have conversation, and listen and help them share their lessons, what they've learned along their journey in terms of their tale, successes and you know, and failures. Like, it, I think it's important that we acknowledge things that we didn't quite do right or we didn't do well that helped us learn to, that helped us grow. Because often you learn a lot more from your mistakes than you do from your successes. How I'm going to do that? So I'm going to focus mainly on connecting with people, you know, like that I've formed like really good relationships with, so that they feel comfortable to open up and share, and mainly from my common areas of interest. So hunt, that being rugby, hunting, fishing, you know, family, local community, that sort of thing. So if you're that way inclined, if you are interested in those topics, then I think you'll really enjoy this podcast, and you'll really enjoy the people that I'm going to connect with, because I've been super fortunate to meet some amazing people that have done some awesome things and that have been through some really hard things also. And I think that they'll resonate really well with you if you are interested in those sort of topics. From a rugby point of view, I want to show more of the person rather than the rugby player. So I think with a lot of, you know, professional athletes or TV personalities or whatever it may be, what the public sees is what is on our screens or on TV, but we don't see what that person does day to day. We don't see what their passions are. We don't see what their interests are or what their bad habit is or whatever it may be. Just get to know a little bit more, so you can feel a little bit more connected. I just finished recording an interview with Sam Kane, and I've joked to a few people. They're like, "Oh, that's a big name to have first up." And I was like, "Yeah, well, but that's only because of a personal relationship that I'm super grateful that Sam made time for me to be able to sit down and share a bit of his, you know, his lighter side." You get to know a lot about Sam Kane, the person, in that podcast. So it's, you know, you'll see a different side of Sam that you don't necessarily see when he's playing or in front of the media, etc. So yeah, I think you'll really enjoy that one. The name. So I thought it was important also to talk about the name and why it's Real Tales with Sweens and why it's spelt like it is. So Real is, for me, I just wanted it to, I want this to be sort of raw and honest. Like, I want it to be real, like in its sort of purest form. So I want to show the true side of people. And also the same with me. So I want to show, I guess, like a real side of me and what I'm, you know, I want to show my vulnerabilities. I want to show what I am, you know, what I have been successful at and why I've got there and what I learned along the way or whatever that may be. And Real, spelt like R-E-E-L, is because I like a play on words. So Real ties into my passion for fishing. So, you know, obviously that's a huge passion of mine, and we're going to connect with a lot of people and get a lot of people from the fishing community on the podcast. So that'll be super exciting if you're into fishing. But even if you're not, hopefully you can see how it really crosses over into anything that you're passionate about when you hear these people share their stories and why they do things, that you'll get a real good understanding of why they do it, and maybe even you'll be interested in going out and trying it. Tales is, like I said a little bit earlier, I just love, you know, conversation, telling yarns, and I want to help people share their tales. I also wanted to, I think it's important to say a few thank yous in terms of people that have helped me, I suppose, get the podcast to this point. And yeah, I suppose I'll start with family. So first of all, to my wife Marie and the two boys for putting up with me going through all the process and in terms of a little bit more time in front of the computer, etc. Has I'm extremely grateful for that. Also, like on the family side, like mum and dad have always been huge supporters of me, and my brothers and everything that we do. But you know, to the point, Dad was so supportive on this that he got in his car and drove to Auckland and went and bought me a microphone after we had our first conversation about why I wanted to do this. So, you know, I'm extremely grateful for that. And here we are. I'm sitting using the microphone. So, thanks very much for that, Dad. And, you know, obviously, Mum, she's always there. No matter what, she always supports us. The NZRU, so the New Zealand Rugby Union and the Waikato Rugby Union, I have to say a massive thank you to both of them for allowing me to use, some of their, their property in terms of, and also Sky Sport. I've grouped Sky Sport into that also. So just around being able to use, some of my rugby footage in terms of like branding to help promote the podcast through my website, through my YouTube channel, things like that. They've been super helpful. But a big part of that was the New Zealand Rugby Players Association, and a special mention has to go to Charlotte there, that she helped me, you know, put me in the right direction, got me talking to the right people at New Zealand Rugby Union, and was just really good to, bounce ideas off, just to make sure that I've gone about it the right way, and just to make sure that I've done it in a way that I'm supported, rather than just going and doing my own thing and then be like, well, actually, you couldn't do that. So it's been super, super helpful, and it's actually been quite an easy process. So you'll probably hear me talk a lot through the podcast in terms of the support network that we have here as rugby players in New Zealand. And I just do want to say a massive thank you to New Zealand Rugby, Waikato Rugby, and the Players Association. Also on that too, I want to thank Luke Crawford. So Luke is the New Zealand Māori's kaumātua, and he gave me the blessing to use the haka like in my jingle. So it's such a powerful thing. It's such a big part of my rugby career, and something that I'm extremely proud of, that I got to play for the New Zealand Māoris. So to be able to use that is just means a lot to me. It's super, super meaningful. It's super powerful, and it's super connecting, which is what this podcast is going to be about. I'm super excited to get Luke on. Luke's going to come on, and he's going to share about the haka. He's going to share about how it was written. I wish we could have Fetu, but sadly Fetu passed away, the man that wrote the haka, but Luke has got really intimate knowledge, and he's going to come on and share that with us. And that'll be a cool episode, because we'll share a little bit about, you know, the Māori environment and what that's like. So that'll be very interesting. But yeah, super grateful, Luke. Thank you so much for your support on that, and look forward to getting you on the podcast. A couple other mentions that I need to make. So Jacinta, thank you so much for your help in terms of setting up my website, and helping, you know, just let me bounce ideas back and forward on, you know, the direction I wanted this to go. And it's been super helpful in terms of getting me set up and getting me thinking about how to market it properly. Pia Titus. So Pia she's the mastermind behind the jingle, behind the trailer you'll see on my YouTube channel. Super helpful, real easy to work with. I also want to thank Paul Martin. So Paul Martin is the guru behind the artwork that you see on my website, on my Instagram, in terms of the logo, the caricature, all of that. Vince is extremely talented. I actually worked with Vince in the community rugby space when I was working at Waikato Rugby. So Vince, thank you very much, mate. Super, super talented guy, and super passionate about junior rugby. So it's awesome to have the support of someone like you. And just with, in terms of, I suppose, the creative part of it, in terms of Jacinta, Pierre, and Paul Martin, Vince, as I know him, you you can find their links through my website. So I'll have links and everything on there. So if you're honestly, if you wanting any sort of marketing, Jacinta's the one you want to talk to. If you're looking at starting your own podcast or anything like that, like Pia's the one to talk to, and especially around like the jingle and that sort of thing. Like she's super creative and really good around that and artwork. Paul Martin is your man. Like seriously, he's got such a talent for it. He does some amazing things and he's just a super genuine nice guy. So yeah, all their links will be on my website. They're all awesome people and they're great to deal with. Like I wouldn't endorse them if they weren't good people, even if they were super talented. If they weren't good people, I wouldn't be, you know, endorsing them or promoting them. They're just super good to work with and, you know, I'm extremely grateful for their support. So that's pretty much me in terms of a wrap up around what the podcast is, what it's going to be about, bit of a background, a little bit of background about myself. I look forward to like sharing more as the podcast grows and as we move through. And yeah, super excited for some of the guests that I do have lined up. And I think that, you know, there'll be something there for everybody, honestly. Like, yeah, a lot of the people, you might not be into hunting or fishing, but I think that you'll really connect well with the people that I'm going to get on rather than what they do. More, it's going to be more about the person and their cool experience and their learnings and how, you know, I'm going to do my best to show how relatable that is to I guess everyday life. So I'm super super excited about it. It's you know, it's been a little bit of a journey to get to this point. It hasn't sort of been too long, but I'm just, yeah, now I'm super excited to just start connecting with people and getting out there. And yeah, like I said, any feedback, please just send it through. Like, honestly, I'm used to criticism. Being a professional rugby player, everyone's an expert in New Zealand, so I can't go to the supermarket without being told what I need to do better on a Saturday. So if you've got any feedback around the podcast, please send it through. Or if you see me, you know, come up and let me know. I'm an open book, so I'm just, yeah, super excited to grow this and to see where it goes. So thank you very much for listening, and Sam's podcast will be the next one up. So Sam Kane, so that, and yeah, it's a good one, so make sure you listen out for that. Awesome, thank you.